Hello, welcome back on my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to explain how to install and use the Geo-SAM plugin for QGIS, which uses the Segment Anything model from Meta. The documentation on GitHub is quite complete, but I'll talk you through. It also has examples that you can work with. So let's follow the installation steps on the documentation page. I'll focus on Windows users that have an NVIDIA video card so we can use GPU calculations to accelerate the encoding process. Therefore, you need to download and install the CUDA toolkit. Follow the link, choose Windows, choose the architecture, there's only one, and choose your Windows version, in my case 11, and choose the installer type. I'll use the executable here. Now click Download. Execute it and follow the on-screen prompts. The next step after installing the CUDA toolkit is to install the GPU version of PyTorch using this command. However, this command uses the CUDA 11.7 version as an example, while we have a newer version. So let's see how we solve that. Look for your OSGeo4W shell and there paste the command. And if we replace it with 12.6, then that doesn't work. And I found out that the newest that is available is 12.4. So I'm going to use here CU124 at the end. And that works. After installing these dependencies, we can do some tests that you can find on pytorch.org. So let's try. It takes some time, but it works. Let's try the other one. It works. And let's see the output. That also looks good. Now there's also a test to see if it can access CUDA. And it says it's true. So that's great. Everything seems to work with the dependencies. Finally, we need to also install Torch Geo and Segment Anything. And that also worked well. So the next step is to install a plugin, and we'll do that through a zip file, because then we have access to the latest version of the source code. So go back to the GitHub page, go to the Code tab, click the green button, and download the zip file. Extract the file. And zip the content. We can rename the zip file. Then start QGIS. I'll use the newest version. There, go to the Plugins Manager. And go to the tab Install from Zip. Browse to the zip file and click Install Plugin. That takes a bit and then you'll get the message that the installation was successful. Now make sure that you have the same plugin folder structure as in the documentation. Close the dialog and go to Settings, User Profiles, and open the current profile folder. And there you will see, under Python plugins, the folder for this plugin. As you see in the documentation, they recommend to use Geo-SAM. So we're going to rename it. Now we need to restart QGIS and reactivate the plugin. After restarting, go to the installed tab, and there I activate Geo-SAM. And here we see that some icons are added. So we can get started by using the plugin. It also adds some menu items here. And here's an explanation of how we can use Geo-SAM. And we'll use it through the plugin. It also explains how you can use it through Python. And what we will do is we're going to use our own image, not the example. So we need to encode the image, which is time consuming, as it says. And then we can apply prompts to it to delineate objects. So the first step is to use the Geo-SAM image encoder from the plugin. And therefore, we need to download SAM checkpoints. The ones that are delivered with the plugin are smaller ones, are trimmed versions. So we need to download these three ones that are mentioned here. So here are these checkpoints, and I copied them to the profile folder with the checkpoints. And then we can get started with an image. So I'm going to download a high resolution aerial photograph from this website, buildmaterial.nl, which has 8 centimeter aerial photographs. And I'm going to go to the city of Groningen in the Netherlands. And I'm just going to download a GeoTIFF in RGB. So here we have loaded the high resolution aerial photograph. And first I'm going to go to the Geo-SAM tool. And I'm going to change some settings here under the options tab, because by default it will load this demo image and I want to work on our own image. And I want to show the boundary when we are done. We'll look at the other settings later. So I'm going to remove the example image. So let's zoom to our layer. There it is. And now I can use the Geo-SAM image encoder to prepare our image for segmentation. Make sure that you choose the three bands. And we're going to draw the extent on the map canvas. Let's choose this residential area. And choose one of the checkpoints. And in this case, I'm going to choose the huge one because we have very detailed information that we need to segment the solar panels on the roofs. We save the result. That will take some time. I'll do a fast forward. So what it does, it will chunk the images and generate the image features. So we can use the prompts to delineate those features. So when it's done, it will go back to this Geo-SAM tool with our area. And in red, you see the bounding box. So let's get started. Zoom into an area, look for solar panels, and see if this tool can assist us in digitizing them quicker. Go to prompts, and there you have several prompts. You have FG for foreground, that's your object of interest, background, what you're not interested in, and bounding box so you can point to an area. You see, when I point to solar panels, it automatically will segment the whole row of solar panels. Sometimes it catches too much, and then I can tune it further by adding one or more prompts. So if I use a bounding box, you see it also works. If I choose the whole area, it will update to all the solar panels in the bounding box, and then I can save the result. So it works feature by feature or polygon by polygon. Let's do another one, choose bounding box, and there you see it nicely delineates the area, although shades can be sometimes a bit confusing. Here the same, even the ones on the steep roof. Let's do some more. You see, now I just need one click and it selects the solar panels on the roof. Here the same. That works really fast. That looks like a more difficult one. And there you see some more confusion. And I'm going to help it a bit by excluding areas to get further precision on the polygon. Let's add these two. And this one, And if we point to background, it will be a bit more precise. Here we see many. That works well with the bounding box. Remove some background. So that's just point and click, and it will delineate them. Here are a few more. Correct it by using background. And this gave nice results. It was quite easy to use. Now, as you see, it's a temporary layer, so we can make it permanent. Save it to a geo package. And let's have a look at the attribute table. And what it stores is also the surface area and what type of prompt we used. So for each feature, you have a combination of three types of prompts, and it stores it in the attribute table. Now let's try a completely different area. This is an agricultural area with parcels that I want to segment. I go through the same procedure by preparing the image in the Geo-SAM image encoder. Draw the extent, use three bands, and in this case I'll use the large checkpoint because we don't need too many details. You can even try to use the base one. And one difference that I make with the previous one is to resample to a 5 meter resolution, because with 8 centimeters we'll have too much noise in this image for our parcels. Okay, that works well. And now we are here to give the prompt. I'm going to enable the preview mode so we can see live what it wants to segment when we move our mouse. And what you see here is that there's often little other polygons segmented besides our large polygon for the parcel. There's a setting here to enable the maximum polygon only, and you see you get much better results. Let's use that. I'll try to segment all the parcels here. You see that the boundary is quite coarse. It has to do with our 5 meter pixels. If you make it smaller, you get a smoother one, or you can, in the end, smooth the polygons. Save the result to a geo package, and this is the result. So you can also smooth this and export that so you have a smoother result. So in conclusion, the Geo-SAM plugin for QGIS works really well. It's still that you need to do one feature at a time by clicking, but it speeds up the whole process. So let's see where Geo-AI is going to bring us in the future. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and looking forward to see you next time.